Good morning everyone. My name is Narmada. I did my graduation in Agriculture Engineering stream and I done my schooling in KSR Metric High Secondary School. I have two siblings and my father is a businessman and my mother is a lecturer. My hobbies are listening music, reading books, and my career is to get an opportunity in teaching line. That is my passion too. My short-term goal is to place in a college so that I can teach and feed new things to children. And my long-term goal is to get a government job. Today, I'm going to take the topic on spoken English. Let us discuss about the topics. Spoken English. Whispers and murmurs, echoes and voices, sounds and words, talks and conversations, speeches and meanings, it's all in here. Welcome to the world of creativity, discussions and expressions. Different greeting styles. What are the different greeting styles? You know, how do you greet a friend? Hi, how are you? How are you doing? How do you greet a relative? How do you greet a relative? You be greeting like, hi uncle, how are you? How are you doing? How is our siblings? How is my cousin? Like that, right? And third thing, how do you greet a teacher? Hi ma'am, how are you doing? Like that. These are the ways, right? Now, meeting a friend after holidays. Hi Sam, a little lazy and bored these days, but it is so great to see you after so many months. He's saying he's so happy and excited that he was seeing his friend. He was so lazy and bored these days, but it is now so happy to see his friend. And his friend just replies like, hello John, I'm meeting you after so long. How have you been? He is asking that, how are you? We have been meeting a long days after. He's asking, how are you? Like that. Let's take a look at the picture in the next slide and describe what we see. We can also share our experience of going to a zoo or on a safari. Well, we will look at this picture. What are these? Inside this picture, you can see different types of animals here. What are those? The birds, like a zebra, lion, monkeys, elephant, giraffe, crocodile and tortoise. You can see those animals inside this slide. Let's make some sentences. Students, you can also try these. Some words will flash on your screen. You have to make as many sentences as you can from each word. You will have 30 seconds per word to make sentences. Excited, angry, happy. These are now you can see these with it. You can tell some sentences. Excited. I was so excited on seeing that Taj Mahal. I was so excited on seeing that cake. Likewise, you should make a word. Excited. I'm so excited to see my brother tomorrow. Like that. And angry. I'm so angry on you. I'm so angry on you. Why are you angry? I'm so angry because you done like that, right? Happy. I'm so happy that I was passed in my examination. I was so happy that I was passed in my examination. Okay, now coming to story. Let's read a story. The Ant and the Grasshopper and Aesop Fable. In a field on summer's day, a grasshopper was hopping about, creeping and singing its chords content. An ant passed by, bearing along with great toy an ear of corn he was taking to the nest. What here they are saying means, on a summer day, a grasshopper was hopping about, chirping and singing on its whole heart. An ant passed by, bearing along with great toil and ear of corn he was taking to the nest. Why not come and chat with me, said the grasshopper. The grasshopper is asking to the ant, why not you come and chat with me, said like that, instead of toiling and moiling in that way. I'm helping to lay up food for the winter, said the ant, and suggest you do the same. What is the ant doing here? He was preparing for the food for the winter. He also suggests the grasshopper to do the same. Why bother about winter? Said the grasshopper. Our grasshopper is telling that, what? Why should we bother about winter? We have got plenty of food at present. But the ant went on its way and continued its toil. But ant was not like it. It was working hard on its so it was taking the food for winter now itself. When the winter came, the grasshopper had no food and found itself dying on hunger. What he was just telling in summer, why we have present, we have some food on present, why should we wait for the winter? He said like that, we can enjoy the moment like that. When the winter came, the grasshopper was he don't have any food on the summer time. He was saying that in the present we can enjoy, but in the winter he has no food and he seems to be dying hunger. Well, he saw the ants distributing every day corn and grain from the stores they had collected in the summer. Then the grasshopper knew it is best to prepare that for days of need. From this lesson, what do you learn? A grasshopper was hopping about, quipping and singing to its heart content. An ant passed by bearing, along with great toil, an ear of corn he was taking to the nest. Why not come and chat with me? Said the grasshopper instead of toiling and moiling in the way. Can you suggest another title to the story? Yeah, tell me something. Yes. The hard-working ant and the lazy grasshopper. So we should be so working and working hard so that we can achieve better in the future. So we should work hard. We should not be like grasshopper. Can you search? Can you read the same story in a tone of anger? Can you read the same story in a tone of excitement? Can you tell the story in your own words? In anger, I'm going to read this in anger. In a field one summer's day, a grasshopper was hopping about, chirping and singing to its heart content. An ant passed by, bearing along with great toil. This is like anger. In excitement, in a field one summer's day, a grasshopper was hopping about, chirping and singing to its great heart's content. An ant passed by, bearing along with great toil, an urn of corn is taking to the nest. And can you tell the story in your own words? What will you say in your words? You can try something. Word of the day. Word stammer. Meaning, what is the meaning of the stammer? Fatter, stumble. A speech disorder involving hesitations and involuntary repetitions of certain sounds. Usage. Where will we be using this? Whenever he was angry, he would begin to stammer slightly. What does it mean? Fatter, stumble. Thank you.